that program is completed. We have to revive now the tripartite agreement that will lead to actual stratigraphic drilling operations in the South China Sea. Seismic operations have been completed. What does seismic operations mean? Seismic operations mean that we have taken a photo shots of the seabed and of the structures below the ocean floor, and we saw anticlines. Anticlines mean reservoirs of oil, potential oil. And so therefore, since there are anticlines or reservoirs possibly bearing oil, the only way to find out is to drill the reservoir if there is oil inside. So that is the next phase. From seismic survey to actual stratigraphic operations. Stratigraphic operations means actual drilling. Why? I say this to you because I used to be president of the Petroleum Association.
And you were exploring oil in the Middle East before.
I discovered oil and gas in the South China Sea. My company, Lan Oil and Basic Petroleum, we were the pioneers in the South China Sea.
Kahit sa Iraq daw, sir, kayo daw yung nagpupunta doon, mga pioneer kayo
doon. Yes, together with Oriental Petroleum and Philodrill and our American partner, Sunoco. Champlain Petroleum were our partners. When we discovered the oil and gas structures in the South China Sea, and not only that, we actually produce oil for the Philippines.
San banda doon, sir? Huh? San
in the South China Sea.
San banda nyo nakuha yung...
About in the northwest Palawan offshore. About 30 miles.
May mga malampaya, wala pa yan. Wala pa rin sila malampaya dyan.
Nandiyan yan. That same area. And but the malampaya is very close to the Philippines. The reed bank and the other areas are contested areas. So 50 miles or 100 miles from the Philippines, going toward ice practice and going toward the Paracels. Paracels goes to Vietnam. This practice goes towards China. So we have claims in these areas together with Malaysia, Vietnam, together with Brunei, and together with Malaysia.
Sir, as an experienced oil driller, sa tingin nyo, sino mas maraming langis? Diyan sa Benham Rice area, sa East Philippine Sea or sa West Philippine Sea?
I suppose both.
Both?
I think both. Pregnant with petroleum oil.
Sir, itong joint undertaking nyo, problema to, huminto to ngayon dahil because of the Supreme Court injunction. Pero pag na-desisyonan to, gagawin blueprint to.
Yeah. So we can
sir, have... Sir, mag-start na ito.
Yes, we can have joint exploration and joint drilling in the South Coast. I'll join you. We'll just finish this. No. Next question.
It's a wreck that can't happen. The earth of the trend of people.
What?
He insists that the both things should be joined.
Which what? One?
Those are chat-chat. Of course, for the revision or amendment of the Constitution. And sabi na members of the joint thing. Senators maintain it should be separated. How should the compromise agreement be reached? Since it has been said that.
Ideally, there should be joint convocation of the constituent assembly. Which means the Senate of Ohio convene as one assembly to consider constitutional amendments. Question. How do they vote?
Yan, yan ang problema.
How do they vote? They can agree to want to vote jointly or separately. So it's a question of the Senate agreeing to vote jointly and the House agreeing to vote jointly. Or
but the Senate would not...
If they cannot agree, they can say we vote separately.
One of the...
Preferably, they should vote jointly. They should act as statesmen. They should act as Filipinos, acting in concert, acting with the highest interest of the Filipino people as their main and primary interest, but not their selfish, prefectural, or regional, partisan views, but if they behave like have the interest of the nation at heart, they should vote jointly.
Sir, but some senators said they would not do that because it is a bicameral body where even a name of a town and changing of the name of a high school have been voted by separately by the two houses of Congress. Ngayon sabi nila, constitution na ito, i-change na natin. Bakit mag-joint, matutunaw kami doon? Then, 22 lang kami, 300 sila.
That can happen, but of course, that's also an exaggeration. Still, I mean, I'm concerned. Great patriotic Philippines. Hindi sa ang concerned, great patriotic Philippines. So, that does not demean the congressmen or the senators. Both are acting in the interest of the Filipino people. Let us consider to both groups. So ideally, the Constituent Assembly should be composed of senators and congressmen voting jointly. But if they cannot agree, then they can vote separately. And so just like in the conference committee in the House, when a bill is filed approved by the House, and another bill approved by the Senate, then a conference committee.
Bicameral conference.
To resolve the differing views of the Senate and the House. So these are the, you know, the Constitution provides specific measures or alternatives or resources in the event of a deadlock.
One big problem that is possibly worked out by a chacha is what we call a political dynasty, political dynasty.
Yeah.
How can it call us composed to competent senators who are said to belong to political dynasty? Be expected to work out the solution to the problem.
What is the question?
How can Senate works and members of the House of Representatives, most of them belong to political dynasty, work out the solution to the problem of political dynasty?
With about 300 congressmen and 24 senators, I don't think more than 15% belong to Congress. So the overwhelming majority are members of Congress who represent themselves and do not belong to powerful families who are in France over the years. But even in the case of the people who are identified with political dynasties, many of them are also statesmen. Some of the Blancos and Serenias of Cebu, they belong to dynasties. In my case, in the in Pangasinan and in the 4th district, we have 3 congressmen differential. But we, nobody accused us of being a dynasty, you know why? When I was a speaker, I was the only congressman. When I retired, and only when I retired, Congresswoman Gina De Venecia. And then, when Gina, Congresswoman Gina ran, it was not by acclamation. She had to fight it out to him. And then, when she retired, our son ran. Our son, Congressman Christopher, ran. And so, we were not... There was a great temptation for the 3 of us to run together. I said, no, we have to do it one at a time. And even when we do it one at a time, we must submit ourselves to the will of the people. This is not a matter of royal succession. You have to compete before the blazing searchlight of public opinion. And if you are deserving, the people will vote for you.
Sir, we have to end. Ladies and gentlemen, we conclude our intellectual conversation with the great speaker, Joe De Venecia. And we talk about charter change. We go to Benham Rice, and then we go back to how the Senate and the House of Representatives. This is political science professor Mortz Ortigosa, a radio commentator also, and with the former 5-time speaker, Jose Joe De Venecia.
Well, I'm so proud to be interviewed by Mortz because he's one of the outstanding intellectuals of Pangasinan and of Northern Philippines. He's a great journalist. Written journalism and oral journalism. Yeah. And I'm very proud to be interviewed.
That is heartwarming, Mr. Speaker.
I am very proud to be interviewed by him. And then I have another dear friend,
veteran,
the publisher and editor, Rivera, who is my old friend of at least 50 years. So I'm proud to be sandwiched between two.
The cousin of Junior Rivera.
Between two great journalists, yes, of the Philippines.
Thank you. Thank you very much, and have a good day, ladies and gentlemen.